Mr. President, honored delegates, ladies and gentlemen,
we shall propose further cooperative efforts between all the nations in weather prediction and eventually in weather control. We shall propose, finally, a global systems of communication satellites linking the whole world in telegraph and telephone and radio and television. The day need not be far away when such a system will televise the proceedings of this body to every corner of the world.
Hi, Steve here. This video may be the most serious and most disheartening video I've ever produced. The only reason I'm going to give you this information is so you can see the only alternative that will bring you any hope after you learn what I'm going to tell you. We live in a world full of darkness, a world of lies and complete deception by those who we should have been able to trust as leaders and decision makers for the nations. Instead, we have a group of leaders who have decided to believe the father of all lies and do his bidding, which includes the extermination of mankind. If this sounds like some far-fetched conspiracy theory, I understand. But keep listening to me as I present the evidence that demands a logical conclusion. Most of you who watch my videos know that we are in the last of the last days. It doesn't take a high IQ to see what's going on. The elites and Luciferians have admitted and don't try to hide their plan. And yet, people still don't take them seriously. They keep us in the false paradigm of what we think will go on forever. If you're someone that knows what the Bible says about the last days, then this won't be that hard for you to believe. But if you don't believe the Bible is true, if you don't believe in God, and you only believe in what you can see, feel, hear, touch, and smell, then you probably won't believe the facts I'm going to lay out right now. The Luciferians have a plan to collapse global food production, kill off over 90% of the human race, devastate natural ecosystems, and pollute the Earth's atmosphere. It's all happening now, and it's all being sold to you under the banner of environmentalism. It's been happening for decades, but now they're not even trying to hide it anymore. Science journals have been talking about spraying aerosols for a long time. Articles from 2003, 2010, 2013, they're not hiding their goal, but they're lying to you about their real purpose. This is their end game for humanity. I know there are people who would say, well, why would they do this? Because won't they die too? Won't they hurt their own families? I believe they've been promised technologies to give them eternal life that you can't even imagine. Their project is called Global Dimming, and it's their ongoing project to spray billions of tons of covering smog into the atmosphere so that pollution levels will block sunlight and halt global warming. This is literally what they're doing now. The very same people who for years have claimed that chemtrails are a conspiracy theory and don't exist, now, all of a sudden, they want to chemtrail the entire planet in order to save us all from global warming. Stratospheric aerosol injection now is the new name for chemtrails in geoengineering. They continue spraying chemtrails into the upper atmosphere using thousands of high altitude flights that release pollution to dim the sun. You know, the very idea of chemtrails was mocked by the media and the science establishment, who have for years claimed the very idea of chemtrails is a lunatic conspiracy theory. So they've changed the name to stratospheric aerosol injection. And now they have a science paper that outlines all the costs involved. Wake Smith and Gernot Wagner lay it all out in plain detail what they're doing in the environmental research letters. Geoengineering is used synonymously with chemtrails. It's the same thing. And now the strategy is openly advocated by scientists to halt so-called climate change, which is not only a complete lie, but a fake science hoax that's been perpetrated on the world by power-hungry globalists who want humanity to surrender to global rule in the name of saving the planet. The study cites the specific aircraft that would be needed to achieve chemtrails pollution. Purpose-built high-altitude tankers with substantial payload capabilities would be deployed to spray sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere. The paper proposes 4,000 flights a year, costing $2.25 billion per year, continuing over 15 years to make sure the atmosphere is significantly polluted to dim the sun and achieve the terraforming goals of the globalists. In the conclusion of their study, they explained the program would require thousands of flights annually by airliner-sized aircraft operating from an international array of bases, making it almost impossible to keep secret. They've been doing it for decades, but because the public has been made aware of so many things in the last few years, their strategy has moved into admitting that they're flying these constant chemtrail flights. Of course, this very program has already been going on, and secrecy isn't necessary when you have the entire media and science establishment condemning any belief in chemtrails as a form of mental illness.
What are those lines in the sky? A jet flies by and leaves behind one of those little white streaks. You're more likely to hear them called chemtrails, an evil government plot. For example, Kylie Jenner recently tweeted her concern, since all the honeybees are getting exterminated, Roseanne Barr thinks someone's destroying our food supply. Prince says it's all about mind control. But what about science?
So just remember, as they continue spraying the skies and dimming the sun, if you point out that they're polluting the skies and dimming the sun, you're a conspiracy theorist. And there's no such thing as chemtrails. No, it's stratospheric aerosol injection now, which sounds real sciencey. That's how this program is already being perpetrated right under your nose. Right now, even while the media runs a global cover-up to dismiss these ideas as bizarre theories. The global controllers hope you never read the science papers because geoengineering is routinely cited and even advocated as the solution to climate change. In their article, they said, stratospheric aerosol injection, or SAI, would require lofting hundreds of thousands to millions of tons of material each year to altitudes up to 12.5 miles. They also asked, could it be done in secret? They talk about the design and costs of the aircraft that could deliver the planned pollution to the upper atmosphere. IPCC in 2018 states, there is high agreement that aircrafts, after some modifications, could inject millions of tons of SO2 in the lower stratosphere. The overall goal of the geoengineering program is to inject 5 million tons of sulfur dioxide, otherwise known as smog, into the atmosphere. The authors actually claim that it's rational to disperse mass pollution across the atmosphere of your own planet. They also claim this program must be conducted purely out of humanitarian and environmental considerations, unquote. They are mad, and they are sick in their minds, and they are the ones making decisions for your death. These scientists are insane sociopaths, and they must be stopped before they murder all of us. If we give these lunatics enough government funding, they will literally murder our planet and destroy human civilization. Only through decades of false propaganda in our public schools have they brainwashed children into believing climate change is real and must be halted. The evil now being proposed to halt this non-existent problem will itself bring about global destruction that children are being warned about. This global pollution and terraforming program will cause global collapse of food crops, global rise in cancer from vitamin D deficiency, global drop in IQs due to increased air pollution, massive loss of habitat and ecosystems due to decreased sunlight and colder temperatures, huge increase in global acid rain that will devastate forests and food crops, decreased plant production of oxygen that's necessary for humans and animals to survive. Even the EPA says sulfur dioxide is a dangerous pollutant that makes it difficult for humans to breathe. Notice the rise in allergies and asthma and every upper respiratory disease. Note that the geoengineering efforts being promoted to dim the sun are based on sulfur dioxide. Short-term exposures to sulfur dioxide can harm the human respiratory system and make breathing difficult. Gaseous sulfur dioxide can harm trees and plants by damaging foliage and decreasing growth. SO2 and other sulfur oxides contribute to acid rain. Remember the cover of Time magazine from 1977, if you're old enough to remember that? How to Survive the Coming Ice Age. Then urged readers to get on board to save the planet, saying, 51 things you can do to make a difference. Today, we're told the most absurd, insane things by these scientists who insist that the climate never changed at all before the year 1920, with the rise of the combustion engine and human activity. And now, we're constantly terrorized by the fake news media into thinking that if we don't pollute the Earth's atmosphere with smog, we'll all somehow die from the rise of carbon dioxide, the number one most important greening nutrient for plants, forests, and food crops. Sadly, they've got about a billion gullible world citizens convinced that this is somehow an amazing idea. What they're doing is absolutely catastrophic to all life in our world. Now the question, is the destruction of humanity deliberate? If so, who would hatch such a nefarious plan? Geoengineering is a worldwide weapon system being deployed to eliminate human life on Earth while terraforming the planet for some other purpose. What we are really witnessing here is the planned terraforming of planet Earth for some other purpose. And by other, I mean other than human. If you want humans to thrive on planet Earth, you wouldn't unleash mass pollution, acid rain, food crop failures, oxygen depletion, and global dimming. You'd try to reduce pollution, support plant life, enhance food crop production, and protect global ecosystems from pollution. Yet, we are subjected to these nefarious geoengineering schemes that directly contradict every principle of sustainable life on Earth. And it's all veiled as a way to save the planet, when what it will really do is destroy life and destroy life support for human beings.
The weather makers have just targeted Atlantic City, New Jersey with a completely engineered winter weather event. How can this be stated with certainty? Because satellite radar imagery that has been recorded proves it. In this animation from Wednesday, December 5th, 2018, a large cell of far above freezing temperature rain migrating west over the far above freezing temperature Atlantic Ocean suddenly flashes out to snow in a vast and irregular pattern, then back to rain in places and back to snow again. Jet aircraft dispersions of toxic ice nucleating chemicals over the migrating moisture create this phenomenon. Examine this animation carefully. It is absolute proof of climate engineering operations in action. Again, above freezing temperature rain cannot suddenly flash or change over to frozen precipitation without the help of the climate engineers and patented processes of chemical ice nucleation. Radio frequency microwave transmissions are another key component of the climate engineering assault. The animation shown is from a transmission installation near Philadelphia. Fluctuating transmission levels helped to facilitate the steering of the migrating moisture into a location that most facilitated the engineered winter weather event. The United States of America, with its massive military and commercial flight operations, is the most capable by far of carrying out large-scale climate engineering operations. China has openly disclosed its engineering of snowstorms in the past. All major powers are fully cooperating on the climate engineering issue for their own reasons and agendas.
Who or what would want to alter the atmosphere, decimate oxygen levels, destroy the food supply, and collapse human civilization? The answer should be obvious. Are Earth's globalists preparing the planet for a post-human era? And is that plan disguised as a climate change emergency course of action so that the sheeple can be told the mass pollution of the skies is a bold plan to save humanity rather than exterminate it? This false flag hoax was designed from the very beginning to convince humanity to support their own extermination. Why are all the globalists suddenly talking about escaping to Mars and terraforming Mars into a habitat where humans can survive? Why the recent focus on the Arctic seed vault to preserve the seeds of life in preparation for a global cataclysm? Why are so many globalist insiders building underground bunkers and living in them? The fairy tale stories we're being told about climate change and how we have to save the planet by polluting the skies are rooted in complete quack science fiction and brainwashing propaganda. If we as humans are stupid enough to destroy our own planet in the name of saving the planet, maybe we deserve what's coming. Are we stupid enough to commit suicide based on a fairy tale hoax? So far, the answer for the Earth and for humans is yes. The very idea that mass polluting the atmosphere with sulfur dioxide would somehow save the planet is rooted in nothing less than advanced psychosis or some other dangerous form of mental illness. The idea that these schemes are marketed under the banner of science, it just shows how twisted the institution of science has become and how willing we are to believe the lies, no matter how ridiculous and absurd. We have been lied to from the day we were born. There are two scriptures in the Bible that I want to point you to. Jesus told us, indeed, if the length of this time had not been limited, no one would survive. But for the sake of those who have been chosen, its length will be limited. And in Revelation 11:18, we see that God will judge those who destroy the earth. The peoples raged, but now your rage has come, the time for the dead to be judged, the time for rewarding your servants, the prophets, and your holy people, those who stand in awe of your name, both small and great. It is also the time for destroying those who destroy the earth. These are comforting words for those of us who follow Christ, knowing that the adversary and those who followed him will be judged for what they've done. But that doesn't change the fact that millions of people will die in these bodies before the Lord Jesus comes back to take ownership of this terraformed earth. If you'd like the peace of knowing that you'll spend eternity with Jesus Christ, there's a link in the description box below that will help you. It will help you pray that prayer of repentance and ask him into your heart and your life. They may destroy this earth. They may kill our bodies. But if you're born again and have a personal relationship with the one who died and rose again from the dead for your sins, your trust in him will assure you of your eternal destiny. Think about it.